Very good morning, my dear students of class 9th. Now I am going to explain the chapter, The Heart of the Tree, chapter number 1 of your treasure trove, a collection of SSC poem and short stories, stanza number 1. Here I am reading the line, you also read the line, and I am going to explain one by one stanza. If you have any problem, please ask me. What does he plant who plants a tree? What does he plant who plants a tree? The poet asks a question to the reader. And he himself provides the answer. The poet asks, when somebody plants a tree, what does he really plant? What does he really plant? He plants, he himself giving the answer, you see. He plants a friend of sun and sky. Obviously, the poet has an answer which has not occurred to us. The poet tells us what a good and happy thing it is to plant a tree, for he says, when you plant a tree, you plant a friend of the sun and the sky. You plant a friend of sun and the sky. He plant the flag of breezes free. You plant a flag of breezes, the shaft of beauty towering high. He plants a home to heaven anigh. You plant a flag of breezes. You plant a home for birds, where the mother bird sings. The shaft of beauty towering high. He plants a home to heaven and I. And I means here near. You plant a home for birds. Here he says, heaven and I means here near. Near heaven. For song and mother croon a bird in hushed and happy twilight heard. He says, you plant a home for the birds, where the mother bird sings in the hushed twilight song that blend. Here he says, the treble of heaven's harmony. These things he plants to plant a tree. You plant a home of birds, where the mother bird sings in the hushed twilight songs that blend beautifully into a harmony of heaven. The poet starts with a question, and in a series of beautiful images himself provides the answer. He calls the tree a friend of the sun and the sky as it grows up upward. It is grows, the tree grows upward. The tree grows upward from day one of its life. From day one of its life. It's fluttering in the breeze, the leaves of the tree flutter. Its fluttering in the breeze is likened to fluttering of the flag. And then it is described as the flag of the invisible breeze on March. The stanza closes as the day draws to its end with the birds returning to their nests and the tree filling out with their twittering and their sound merging with other sounds around as the tree disappears into darkness. The harmony of heaven replacing all the visible world. In Shanza 2, he says, he plants cool shade and tender rain and seed and bud of days to be. The poet repeats the question as to what exactly a person does when he plants a tree. The planted trees provide cool shade in summer and bring gentle rain. It provides seeds and birds which bloom and mature for planting more trees. A year that fade and flush again, he plants the glory of the plain. As seasons and times go by, some trees fade away. Some trees fade away means died. Some new ones are planted, and for some, fresh growth takes place. And thus, he says, the poet says, he plants the glory of the plain, and thus, those who plant trees and care for them give glory to the land. They glorify the land. He plants the forest heritage. They help in developing the heritage of the forest and provide for harvesting nature's benefits. The harvest of a coming age. The joy that unborn I shall see, these things he plants to plant a tree. They help in developing the heritage of the forest and provide for harvesting nature's benefits. Generations of unborn children, those who have not born, those who have not come in this world, generations of unborn children shall have great joy seeing the forest's heritage and nature's glories. These are the legacy one who plants the tree provides for the next generation. Now, stanza number 3 here. The last stanza, he plants in sap and leaf and wood in love of home and loyalty and far cast thought of civic good, his blessings on the neighborhood. For the third time, the poet repeats the same question asked in the earlier two stanzas. People plant trees primarily due to love and loyalty to one's own home and family and a thought of future good. In love of home and loyalty and a thought of future good and far cast thought of civic good, his blessings on the neighborhood. These a tree provide all required nutrients, minerals and natural resources. One who plants a tree brings blessings of God. nature who nurtures and balances the growth of this land. He says, who in the hollow of his hand holds all the growth of all our land, a nation's growth from sea to sea, stirs in his heart who plants a tree. One who plants a tree brings blessings of God. Thus, poet says, one who plants trees has something stirring in his heart to show care and concern for the growth of a nation from one boundary to the another boundary, to the one boundary to the other. So planting a tree is like planting a new nation which will bring peace and harmony. In the third stanza, the poet speaks about the great contribution the man who plants trees make to his home and society. The poet suggests that planting of tree brings the blessings of God, who holds, sustains, and oversees the growth of everything on the land we live. The use of his blessings, as is written in capital, you see, his blessing and our land is a relation suggesting God and people. The poet ultimately answers his questions in the last two lines of the poem. You see, here written, a nation's growth from sea to sea stirs in his heart who plants a tree. The man who plants trees is the one who desires for the growth of a nation from one end to the other, with rich natural vegetation. This will result in peace and harmony on earth. Dear student, by this way, the poem ends. If you have any problem, please ask me, and you please complete your work. Thank you so much.